I jotted down the points which I want to share at the start of the lecture, because my lecture will be based in explaining all these 5 points. So, I wrote that I am unable to see any direct role of anthropologists in corona pandemic, as they have no direct methods to interpret, to intervene, except point one, they can closely observe the fear impact on family, community, and cultural areas. Number two, they can participate as corona warriors in spreading the government messages to communities of their studied area as agent of change in behavior pattern to create awareness, to change the social behavior prescribed for corona pandemic. Number third, the anthropologist can closely observe the social behavior of people under lockdown. This is very important. Number fourth, they can study the aftermath impact of pandemic on social institutions like family, community, and society at large. Then, the fifth one came to my mind, that as an applied anthropologist, they can assist the government machinery in behavior change communication. This is what I placed on my Facebook page on 27th morning. Just after 10 minutes, it was utter surprise to me that Professor Bhagwan Rao of IBRD Calcutta responded, highlighting ecology and nature and other applied aspects, followed by Ritu Banerjee with the idea of biological anthropology, Anuj with urban anthropology, Professor A.R. Srivastava on culture and feelings. By the second half of the day, a Pradeep came forward and wrote on my wall, highlighting the migrant pigeon and land. That Professor Abhijit Guha also joined. Finally, by the evening, Professor Mohan Kumar Gautam from Netherlands is my senior colleague. He boosted my confidence to speak on the subject. That's how I am here before you. So friends, let us have an anthropological look at the pandemic called COVID-19. As you all know, the pandemics are neither new to human race nor to anthropologists. The corona pandemic is one like them. Currently, COVID-19 is a disease on a global scale, but it is not a universal phenomenon. Anthropological research is essential for placing it in the context. The coronavirus outbreak raises fundamental questions about the politics and narratives of crisis, as well as about our ordinary everyday lives and society. This is important. Now, the outbreak or epidemics, as you all know, are technical terms from epidemiology. They are used for temporal, geographical, and quantitative classification of infectious diseases. These terms are fundamental for establishing surveillance and control, levels of attention and protocol of action. That is how this is being addressed. Now everyone is talking about COVID-19. But what's fact and what's misinformation? This has to be segregated. While understanding the epidemiological components of the virus are essential, we also need social science perspective included to ensure the best collaboration possible across expertise. It is not only the biological aspect, but it is also the anthropologists who can contribute to study the impact of this. Now friends, in the case of COVID-19, for example, when several people in Wuhan showed symptoms of a serious and unknown respiratory infection in a short period of time, Chinese authorities sounded the alarm, warning about the beginning of an outbreak. the presence of a new variety of the coronavirus virus was quickly identified. Soon after, similar cases also appeared in other cities and regions of China and abroad. It was the beginning of an epidemic. Numbers of diseases continued to rise in more countries and continents covering almost the entire globe. Probably by now there are 122 countries infected by this COVID-19. So the WHO declared what is considered the worst scenario, that is the pandemic. Now here the question is, how can anthropology act in events described to be at the global scale? The anthropologists are known for their micro studies in the field. But this is a global phenomena. So the question came to my mind, how the anthropologists can study these COVID impacts. I thought, accordingly, on January 20, 2020, the World Health Organization declared COVID-19 a public health emergency of international concern. On March 11, WHO assessment was shifted to declare COVID-19 a pandemic. And since that time, the virus has spread to 184 countries and surpasses 1.2 million confirmed cases globally. This is a data 3-4 days old, means of last week. Now, where our country stands in this case? The data is from 27th April 2020. The number and figures of these deaths occurring in the world have completely engulfed the mind of our countrymen. In comparison to these millions of deaths, the figure of 400 to 500 corona deaths in India is almost equal to zero. Of the 31,332, this is a figure of as on 27th April. Today it has crossed up to 35,000. Positive cases that are being presented, 60% do not have any disease. Despite this, there is such a situation of hallucinations that instead of being convinced by asymptomatic cases, ISCO has become a matter of great concern. All this is a miracle of mathematical modeling. This is, to my mind, what I think, or what some of my colleagues think. India adopted social distancing and lockdown quickly, so situation of a spread may be set to under control in comparison to Europe and America. We have taken quick action than those people. But the sudden fearful labor crowd become restless as they lost their job and felt insecure at the place of their work, like Bombay, Jaipur, Delhi, and other metro cities. So, this sudden fearful labor crowd become restless as they lost their job and felt insecure at the place of their work. So they suddenly ran towards their home villages in the distant states. The government appeal of lockdown badly shattered, creating a chaotic situation. Another unexpected situation emerged after Jamati conference in Delhi. As you all know, must have heard through TV and newspapers. Many of participants having corona load is spread from length and width of the country. This was the most unexpected event that had happened. This made the situation worse for administration to control. But somehow, they are managing it by identifying these participants and putting them under quarantine. So friends, this is the situation in our country. As on 29th April 2020, if you look at the statistics of our country, then there were 31,332 confirmed cases of coronavirus infection. There were 1,008 deaths, 7,747 people recovered, and the closed cases were 8,755. If we look at that in the terms of percentage, this 7,747 cure comes to 88% cure, which is quite appreciable, who were recovered and discharged. And deaths were only 12% out of the cases. Now, let me elaborate my 5 points which I shared with you at the start of my lecture. Now, coming to point number one, that is, anthropologists can closely observe the fear impact on family, community, and cultural area. This is my first submission, that anthropologists can closely observe the fear impact. Fear is very important here on family, community, and cultural areas. Let me explain it. Psychologically, in the 70s, as cholera epidemic spread all over the world, then someone in America asked how to survive this epidemic, and which is also very relevant today in relation to corona. People are asking the same question which they asked in 70s. How to survive this pandemic? This is the question we are asking wrongly. The question should have been that, say something about the fear that has died in our mind due to the pandemic. How to avoid this fear? This should have been our first question. Because it is very easy to avoid the virus. But the fear that has seated within us and most of the people of the world is very difficult to avoid. This is a very important subject, looking to the fear aspect of the pandemic. There is a sizable number of persons who are highlighting the positive change in families and communities due to fear created by corona. Others are using it as a reminder of our sin against nature and suggesting that this is an opportunity to think anew. What they are suggesting? They are suggesting as opportunity to think anew. So, while I have been harping on the negative aspects of the fear, the need to overcome fear, there are others who think otherwise. It will be useful to have your perspective from both sides. So, friends, you should think to address this fear in the minds of people due to this corona pandemic. It will be useful to have perspective from both sides, from the negative side as well as from the positive sides. Now, friends, this dreadful shadow of fear or terrified person mind, a world striken by the fear of corona, is about to enter a new era. That is what I can foresee. This tragedy has hit social relations, has made the founding human community of the world lonely. It is pushing a creature called social animal to private life. As you all know, man is a social animal, but this fear of corona is putting us in private. Certainly, everyone will be helpful in the creation of era of new corona culture. My learned friend, professor from Pondicherry University, mentioned a term corona culture. This I throw before you to accept or to discuss on it. So, but I like the term, that's corona culture. Therefore, I use it that shortly everyone will be helpful in creation of the era of new corona culture. The fear of death compels man to do everything that he has done, that he doesn't want. This virus is out of the grip of human beings. Let me remind you again. This virus is out of the grip of human beings. But as long as this invisible virus will remain around us by becoming an invisible factor of death, or will keep the illusion of being several times throughout the day, we will wash hands, keep oneself 6 feet away from the human being. Even if you find a place, the distance will remain. We will be afraid to travel. We will be constantly aware not to go where there is too much crowd. Relationships that require physical proximity will also be dealt with in the shadow of fear. The economic crisis will be so deep that marriages or other social activities, rituals will be carried out with utmost simplicity. These are the things going to happen after corona. People will avoid wasteful expenditure. This is, will be a positive aspect of corona impact. That people will avoid wasteful expenditure and status maintenance. This corona fear will keep us going for the next 25 years. This is what I think. It may be less, may be more. It all depends on your own calculations and forecasts. It is possible that we have to return to our traditional, that what we call the Sanatani or the Hindu, or the traditional rites, thoughts, behaviors of living in isolation. Our Rishi Munis used to live in isolation. So they have a longer life than ours. So probably, this corona fear will lead us to have a lonely life. Whether it will be beneficial or not, I can't foretell right now. I am thinking not only on the local characteristic about certain population, younger or older, rich or poor, etc., and their wage of life. As a dietary and a smoking habits, physical exercise, but also about work routines, including growing precariousness. Anthropological research implies the sharing of experiences and enhancing of unique environments. So, pandemics are not only metrics, they must to be considered from a perspective of situated lives and sensibilities, human sensibility. Pandemics are also embodied experiences, and each experience counts. Each experience makes history. And as anthropologists, we follow these histories and we learn from them. Point number two, which I want to share with you. Anthropologists can participate as corona warriors in spreading the government message to communities of their situated studied area as agent of change in the behavior pattern to create awareness. So the anthropologist can take a role of agent of change. This was my second thought. To explain this, let me share with you. Say children are less at risk is the disregard many who are still under Bangladesh in low income country. Let's take an example. Even a tribal suggestion like water and soap save lives. Washing hands with water and soap. If we look into the case in the countries chronologically dry and soap is a luxurious item like Brazil, what will happen? In addition, practicing social isolation at home implies having a home and having enough separate rooms for its residents. One room for each person. This is also a luxury. Whether it is possible in the poor households in African countries as well as in our country too. One of our anthropologist colleagues, known as Deborah Dirich, has already warned that home is not always a safe place for quarantine, especially for women in times of high rates of domestic violence and feminicide. So this has come as a result from the earlier studies of pandemics, which is true even for corona pandemic. Many people have been saying that the virus is democratic. The virus is democratic. It attacks all people. But this virus democracy hides deep unequal social strata. The behavior pattern of the poor, the behavior pattern of the rich. I have heard my friends saying that this is a rich man's disease. This disease has come by aeroplane from China and spread to the other country. I don't know what's the truth. But people are saying this. Now, point number third. The anthropologists closely observe maintaining social distance, the social behaviors of people under lockdown. This is important. If we want to involve ourselves as an anthropologist, then we have to start right from now. That is, this is the third phase of lockdown that has started today. Here, the social behavior of millions of people, daily wage earners who lost their job in metropolis and moved on their feet, deciding to reach home thousands of miles away. How they are coping with the fear of extension of corona lockdown for more days. That is the third phase starting from today. How they are getting bread and butter for their daily survival. How government machinery is assisting them to survive. Also, the gap between promises and ground reality. That has to be looked into as an anthropologist. I am also referring here to environmental situation, like daily exposure to pollution and local effects of climate change. In addition, I am thinking of fundamental rights, such as the access to information and basic health, and sources of water and safe food. Enacting universal risk group such as the elderly needs to take into account what it is to live in different places and the age and retirement policies in different contexts. This is not only I'm thinking in India, but my colleagues in USA are also thinking on this line. My colleagues in Leiden, the Netherlands, are also thinking on this line. Taking it further, this point leaves us with many questions to consider. How do we care at a distance? I repeat, how do we care at a distance? Means anthropologist has to study a phenomena at a distance. Our most reliable tool, that is participant observation, is not going to help us in this lockdown period. Therefore, we have to think, we have to devise how to reach this pandemic or the behavior of the people in the community. Friends, I am happy. I will be sharing at the end of my lecture how we can conduct field work through the modern techniques or technologies and devices. But here, what is good care? We need to think by governments for populations and by individuals who now through the very intimacy that is so often valued in caregiving. This caregiving may endanger the life of a person who is not affected with coronavirus. This is another challenge before us. How may we rethink our normative orders of sociality, citizenship distribution, or care and human nature relations? This is very important. What possible models and initiative do we already see emerging in our dynamic social world? Writing in